All right, well, I'm leaving my hostel in Paris now, getting ready to board a train to Germany, where I'm gonna hang out there at a friend's place for a couple days, get my stuff sorted, and go from there. I wanna say that I'm waking up at the ass crack of dawn, but it's really so early that there are still drunk people out from, well, tonight. And that's what you gotta do to save some money over here, is just travel really early. And when you are really tired and uncomfortable, but save 20 euro. So good for that. Now let's see if I can make my way to the train station. All right, now I'm arriving at the metro station right here. And I'm going to attempt to show you how to buy a ticket for one of these metros. Again, I tried last time, but was accosted by, I don't know if it's a gypsy or something, I'm just gonna use it as a blanket term, some gypsy person. And I don't think I can show that recording. Didn't end terribly well. So, you need to use one of these green machines. The thing that threw me off first is, to navigate, you use this little wheel here. It's not a touch screen. So, I need to work on that. Really, just, you don't even have to turn it into English, just stay on the top option, hit the little button, 1.70 euro, put your money in, little ticket's gonna print from here. And your money should come out, there we go. Figure out where you're going using these little signs. I know for everyone that likes to be late or just on time when they're going somewhere, do not do that at Gare du Nord in Paris. This is a huge train station and it takes forever to get from one end to the other. Oh yeah, and save your train ticket if you want to escape the train system here. Looks like this, because you have to use it to get out. I guess you just jump over if you forget it. Since if you're a tourist, no one would prompt. So we're finally in the train part. We have to go to track 7. You can see the Thalys train right there. It is by far one of the coolest looking trains, at least in Europe, as far as trains go. It's a big purple thing. And it's a high speed train. It'll take you Paris to Cologne, I think like 3 hours. And it also goes to a bunch of other places. So you don't actually have to wait in line or have any of that hassle at the train station. Highly recommend that. So here we go. Best thing about the train, dining car. Ham and cheese, freshly toasted. Strawberry yogurts. Chocolate muffin, apple juice. All very good and very expensive. But it's nice to be able to get up and actually walk around. Get some fresh food. All right, finally made it to Cologne. So let me show you the best part about Cologne. Leave the train station and look up. Really just an impressive church. Pretty much the only thing that we didn't blow up in World War II in this city. We missed it, and the pictures of that are quite incredible. Now I'm gonna go around the front and show it to you, and once again, since I'm in Europe, try to avoid the gypsies. Check out the street performers getting ready. Those guys are actually kind of cool. At least at first. After a while, they just piss you off. All right. This thing right here is the, I guess, spire on top of the church is the actual size of it. And it just shows you how high up this church is. And let's get ready to take a look. Fire behind me is on the very top, right up there. Everyone always talks about Notre Dame in Paris. This is significantly more impressive, and this little video definitely isn't going to do it justice. To be honest with you, this is the coolest thing in Cologne. Once you've seen this, walk up to the top if you'd like, get a view of the city, and there's not too much else more to see here. So it's definitely worth a visit just to see this church though, and go inside.